Hello there, friends. Welcome back. My birthday, as it turns out, is nearly upon us. It's coming up a little later this week, as a matter of fact. And I thought it might be fun to use the upcoming birthday as an excuse to film a page-turning video where we would look at and browse through a magazine that was published in the same month that I was born. And we have such a magazine right here. This is a copy of Life magazine, published in March of 1967, which is the same month that I was published. So I thought we would do some page turning and get some nice paper sounds. We have our little brush that I like using as a pointer in several videos on this channel. And I thought it would be fun and hopefully relaxing and maybe triggering to flip through this magazine, in particular paying attention to advertisements. I love looking at advertisements from years past. I think you can tell so much about a society or a culture, or at least the people who are trying to sell things to that society or culture, by looking at advertising, particularly for items that are still in use and for sale today. It's, at the very least, nostalgic and, at the most, sometimes humorous and maybe even hilarious to see how some of these things were advertised back in the day. So, settle in, relax, and let's start flipping through this copy of Life magazine. We'll listen to the sounds of the paper and look at some of these ads, okay? Nice and Easy by Clairol. I've never been a Clairol customer, but I assume Clairol is still in business. I believe it is. The closer he gets, the better you look. And Murine, of course. I do believe this product is still available today. Put down that book you just can't put down. Weary eyes caused by too much reading. That goes for reading this ad. I wonder if that also applies to reading things from our electronic devices these days. The paper in this magazine is a thin, kind of a semi-gloss paper. because it's so thin, but also so big. It has a has an interesting what Maria would call a heartbeat that we can listen to. Kind of reminds me of Foley artists that work in film. Those are the folks that use mechanical items to put the sounds of things back into film, like footsteps and doors closing and things like that. Have you ever seen when they use a really thin sheet of metal and kind of wobble it to create the sound of thunder? That's what these pages remind me of. Electric typewriters from Smith Corona. Don't see much of these every day. Not anymore. The world's first electric portables that would let you power space like lightning. Cigarettes, of course. Lots of cigarette ads in print these days. The Sun Shears by Max Factor. A double page ad, and look at these colors. And this earring. On her lips, sheer peach. On her nails, cream peach nail satin. She's all about the peach. New York Life, it's an insurance company. Brock's, the candy company. They're absolutely still around. This was a magazine from March, so they're advertising the upcoming Easter candy season. U.S. savings bonds. General Electric advertising the GE washer, making a big deal about all of these man-made fibers that were getting used for clothing. 1910 rayon, nylon in 38, Orlon 44, Dacron in 46, wash and wear in 55, permanent press 65, and the 1967 GE washer in this attractive brown color, ready for whatever comes next. And they start at about $200. This is an interesting ad. An ad for flying lessons. Special offer, your first flying lesson. Was this a thing? Trying to sell the idea of becoming a pilot as a recreation. More people learn to fly in Cessnas than in all other airplanes. Another tobacco ad. The Diplomat White Owl. Cigars. These two pages of ads are interesting. If you look down here, you see the page number says R1. I think the R stood for regional. I don't remember where I got this magazine. It was probably a flea market or an antique store or something like that. But the original subscriber 50 years ago lived in a town in very northern Indiana, I believe. And these two ads are regionally targeted to the Midwest. The Gen Air Corporation here, I believe, was headquartered in Indianapolis, in the center of Indiana. And this ad about taking up fish and aquarium as a hobby lists all these dealers that are from the Indiana and Kentucky, Ohio, Tennessee, West Virginia area. So this area of the magazine must have been tailored with regional specific ads and looked different depending on what part of the country you bought your magazine from. At least I assume. Similar with this, I believe Greenfield was a brand owned by Eli Lilly, focused, as you can see, on lawn care products. And Greenfield is also a name of a city in the state of Indiana where Eli Lilly is also headquartered. So there's probably a connection there. I don't know if Greenfield is still around. I kind of doubt it, but I'm not sure about that. 50-cent coupon that expires in August of 67. We're a little late. And Pan Am, one of the many airline companies that are not around anymore. I think Pan Am folded in the early 1990s. Mutual of New York, more insurance. Perfume, cologne by Max Factor, the new Dodge A108 king size van. It's got the largest fuel tank, a foot and a half longer in the wheelbase. Dodge builds tough trucks. The Hammond Organ Company. These folks are very much enjoying their household Hammond organ. It's the new J100. I wonder if, I don't know if this is one of those wind-powered organs where you would turn it on and a fan would start blowing and it would blow air through the mechanism somehow, and that's what made the sounds. I think we had one of those when we were growing up. Only $745 if you want it in mahogany. Other finishes slightly higher. The Gillette Super Stainless. Pretty sure Gillette's still around. You'll notice how many ads we've gone through before we've even gotten to the masthead page. I'm pretty sure that has not changed in modern magazines either. Skill Power Tools. And Contact. It's a cold medicine. I remember long ago TV commercials about Contact because they showed the capsule with all the little beads inside, and I think they opened up one of them in slow motion, and it was probably a large mock-up of a capsule, and all the little beads were actually colored tennis balls or something like that. But they would open up one of these in slow motion and all of the little tennis balls would spill out and bounce everywhere. It's an early memory I have of TV advertising. Sylvania. These big old console televisions. Is it a television? Is it furniture? Well, in 1967, they were one in the same. I love an advertisement that has, you know, a picture or a painting of what might have been a living area from the late 60s. This all ties into a designer named Yale Burge. Looks like he drew this up. Did anyone live in a house in the late 60s that had a room that looked like this? If so, you should tell me about it in the comments. I think we didn't have a TV that looked like this, but we did have a record player that was in a big wide console type of a deal. The Ford Cortina. Ford's Model C. For under $2,000 or as little as $40 a month. Introducing another better idea from Ford. See the yellow pages for the name and address of your nearest Ford Cortina dealer. Atlas Plycron. The round tire. It's got a precision engraved mold. So apparently in 1967 they discovered that what you really want in a tire is for it to be round. That's good news. Loudon Wainwright. I don't know if this is an article or an editorial of some sort. Ah, Maytag. The Dependable Automatics. Nothing. nothing's been able to wear out their 10-year-old Maytag. When I was growing up, the Maytag advertising was all about the plight of the Maytag repairman. Do you remember him? How he was never busy because Maytags never broke down. It's Admiral, the mark of quality throughout the world. Portable televisions. The Admiral Instant Play Portable gives you perfect pictures outdoors, too. So the screen must help with the glare of the sun. And I love this comment here. Admiral Sunshield TV also gives you instant play. Just turn it on. Picture and sound are there immediately. No waiting for warm-up. Do you remember when these cathode ray tube style of televisions, you didn't get a picture immediately when you turn it on? The picture kind of faded in after a few seconds. And then when you would turn the TV off, the picture wouldn't disappear immediately. It would many times collapse into a little dot in the middle of the screen that would then fade away after a few seconds. My brother and I had an Atari 2600 video game system. And, you know, that was a big deal at the time, but we had it plugged into about a 19-inch black and white television. That's what we played our video games on at the time. I still remember getting up to the max score of 1,000,000 points on Activision's Chopper Command game, all on a black and white television. This is a big article on Henry Luce. The timing of this magazine, this March 67 magazine, is interesting. It's interesting that this is the one we're talking about today. Henry Luce was the founder of Time magazine, and he also founded Fortune magazine, and he also founded this version of Life magazine, the version that we're most familiar with in the modern world. There was a magazine called Life magazine that started in 1883 in the United States. And it was a general interest and light humor magazine. And Henry Luce bought the rights to the name Life in 1936 so that he could transform it into a weekly publication that focused on photojournalism. Henry Luce's opinion was that photos could tell a story on their own rather than just being there to illustrate text. And so he kind of rebranded Life as a weekly publication to do just that. And it ran as a weekly, like this one, from 1936 to 1972. And then it stopped its life as a weekly and started being used for intermittent special editions until 1978. And then it began to be published as a monthly from 78 to the year 2000. Then it was back down to just being used for special editions for the next 4 years till 2004. And then it spent 3 years as a weekly newspaper supplement from 2004 to 2007, where it was directly competing with things in the United States such as Parade and USA Weekend. And then 2007 was the last time they used Life as a publication in any way, not counting website and things like that. But Henry Luce was the one who was responsible for all of that, and he passed away in February of 1967. And so this March edition had a retrospective article on him. And that's him. Tons of pictures of him with notable world leaders and entertainers. That's Danny Kaye there. Douglas MacArthur. Kennedy, of course. Chiang Kai-shek. Winston Churchill. Lyndon Johnson, Eisenhower, pictures from his life, this was his wife, Claire Booth Luce. They were married in 1935. She was an author and a playwright, a member of Congress from Connecticut, and also the U.S. ambassador to Italy from 1953 to 1956. It's understandable that they would devote quite a few pages to him in this issue. And not to make light of his contributions or his life, of course, but we come right out of this article about him to this ridiculous spread here with all of these Campbells and Swanson and Franco-American TV dinnery type of things. I don't know if this is still true, but back then Campbell owned Swanson and V8 and Franco-American and Bounty. Not one of these Campbell dishes had been introduced 3 years ago. So the late 60s was responsible for unleashing classics slash horrors such as the Swanson Frozen Beans and Franks dinner, the Swanson Frozen Spaghetti and Meatball Dinner, SpaghettiOs, of course, which comes in a can. I really don't know if they still make TV dinners for the conventional oven anymore. That's what these aluminum trays were for. I know they still make these kinds of dinners for the microwave that use a non-metallic tray. I will confess that these sometimes did cross our table when I was a kid, but I haven't had occasion to encounter a TV dinner in some years. So they might still be out there. The 22 dishes you see here are our newcomers. We'd be proud to have you try them. There you go. Budweiser, of course. Still around. More tobacco. Cool filter kings. I was never picked up the habit myself, but there's an ad. These folks seem to be having a good time. It's an article about an Austrian industrialist named Charles Bloodhorn. He was the guy who, among many other things, established the company that went on to become Gulf and Western. Cocktails, endorsed by Fernando Lamas, star of stage, screen, and TV. I don't know if these are Heblein cocktails. Is it me, or is this tagline a little bit underwhelming? Better than most people make. Is that really the best way to sell yourself? Better than most people make? It's like, hey, buy our product. We're not bad. Fernando Lamas. Vacation, advertising vacations for Southern California over here. Then, of course, we have the 1967 Ford Mustang. Strike a blow for originality. Take the Mustang pledge. Still the original and lowest priced car of its kind with bucket seats. The Mustang. I'm a little bit of a sucker for classic lines like this. My favorite was always the 1964 Buick Riviera. That had a very similar design on the side as this Mustang does. Mogan David. Wines. Aunt Jemima. Deluxe Easy Pour Pancake Mix and Armor Bacon. Buy Armor Star Bacon and save 8 cents on the pancake mix. 8 cents. I wonder how much of a discount, percentage-wise, that really was. We're still in the article about the Austrian industrialist here. AT&T and associated companies. When you're relaxing on a Sunday afternoon, why not call long distance and share your happy family feeling with folks who love you? There's no need to wait till Sunday evening. Lowest interstate rates are in effect all day. This harkens back to a time when there were different long distance rates for different parts of the day, different parts of the week, and generally Sunday evening had the lowest long distance rates state to state. It's really kind of a, now with, you know, everybody on data plans and using cell phones, this is a quaint but obsolete concept. Old granddad, head of the bourbon family. Kentucky straight bourbon whiskeys. Here's an article about ultrasonic nebulizers. Apparently, this concept of putting medicine in water and then using ultrasonic waves to atomize the water, turn it into a mist, and then breathing in the medicine was something that was just being toyed with back in the late 60s. These days, you can look up ultrasonic nebulizer on something like Amazon and find a large selection of nebulizers for the home. So, this is still very much an established way of administering some kinds of medicine, although I don't believe the recommended use for the home anymore involves surrounding the patient in plastic to hold the mist in. But ultrasonic nebulizers are absolutely a thing. The International Paper Company. If you need anything new from the paper industry, you can probably get it from us. Again, somewhat of an underwhelming ad approach, I think. I think these people needed to hook up with the folks from Mad Men. Nebulizer. Diet Right Cola, America's number one low-calorie cola, and to prove it, here's jazz flautist Paul Horn with his bottle of Diet Right. Bottle, glass bottles. Love the glass bottles and the cartons. So this is a photo essay from John Loengard. I mentioned before that Henry Luce's vision for life was that pictures could tell a story, so the focus was supposed to really be on photojournalism. And so this is one of two features in this copy of the magazine with a bent on photojournalism. In this one, John Loengard has a apartment in New York somewhere, Manhattan perhaps, and this is a collection of photographs that he was able to take from the windows of the place that he lives. John Loengard is still alive. He's 83 years old now. He joined Life magazine in 1961 And he was the picture editor for the company from 1973 until 1987. In 2004, he was given the Henry Luce Lifetime Achievement Award from Time Incorporated. And in 2005, American Photo Magazine identified him as one of the 100 most influential people in photography. I don't know if this counts as any of his best work. I probably assume not, but that's a little more about what became of Mr. Loengard. Silhouetted horizon. And that's nice too. Volkswagen. Their unique construction keeps dampness out. Floating Volkswagens. And in the theater section of the magazine, a little bit about Lynn Redgrave. A play called Black Comedy. The press photos for the play. They look a little bit staged. Hoover. Stop washing your dirty linen in public. Stop going to the laundromat and get your own clothes washer, seems to be saying here. The Hoover spin drying washer. There's never been a washer quite like it. It's portable. We're still talking about black comedy here. Mayflower. It's a moving company. Chevrolet. It's a big sale. Chevy's Bonanza sale, and here's folks from the TV show Bonanza. Watch Dan Blocker, Michael Landon, and Lauren Green, stars of Chevrolet's Bonanza on NBC TV next Sunday night. This is the second photo essay in this issue of the magazine. And this one was photographed by Co Rentmeester. Co Rentmeester is also still alive. He's 81 years old now. This is a photo essay about paratroopers in Vietnam. Rentmeester is a very interesting fellow. He was actually a Dutch rower. He competed for the Netherlands in rowing in the 1960 Summer Olympic Games in Rome. And then he moved to the United States and studied photography and started as a freelance photographer for life in 1965. From 1966 to 69, he was in Asia mostly, doing a lot of Vietnam coverage. At one point, he took a picture of a commander of an M48 Patton tank looking through a scope or a rangefinder or something like that. And that photograph won the 1967 World Press Photo of the Year. And it was the first color photograph ever to win that award. He was actually wounded by a Viet Cong sniper near Saigon and came back to the United States in 1972. Ford has a better idea. Meet the safest young drivers in America. Fifty years later, it would be interesting to know if any of these people show up on Facebook, huh? Here. This is an article and interview with none other than Charlie Chaplin, the little tramp himself. It's what Charlie Chaplin looked like in 1967. At his home in Switzerland. He was 77 years old at this time. Jockey, it's your neck. The Power Knit t-shirt. The Hot Point Total Clean Electric Range in olive, or whatever, avocado. That's what they always called this appliance color, right? In the late 60s and early 70s, avocado. My goodness. An article from the President's Council on Physical Fitness, lobbying for open recreation area nights in the communities. GM, the Pontiac Grand Prix. The 400 cubic inch V8. 350 horsepower. And I'm sure it was just fine on gas mileage. Sunkissed are obviously still around. Oranges from California and Arizona. The Kodak Instamatic 804. Use this cartridge film. I think this was called this film format was called 126, I think. I might be wrong about that. You never do any figuring with this camera. Built-in computer does it for you, making the correct exposure setting automatically for daylight and for flash. Might all. They're also still around. Might all makes the difference between poor Deborah and gay Deborah. Silver cleaner. Shoes. It's a really wide variety of products being sold or advertised in these magazines. Bathtub caulk. Beacons or beckons, moving and storage. Nutriment, a nutritionally complete food. We're still in the Chaplin article here, but we're also learning about Michigan, tourism in Michigan. I'm from the Midwest, and I've been to Michigan several summers the past 10 years or so. It is a pretty awesome place. Pittsburgh paints. At last, latex enamel. It washes off. It washes off of you, but not off of walls. The book review. I think this is about cooking for kids, or helping to get kids into cooking. Anderson window walls. This is the kind of stuff I still love to this day. Modern archaeology. This is a little article about a shipwreck. Things that they found in a shipwreck. I believe these items went to auction. I love this stuff. I was also a big fan of globes. I still am. This is an interesting kind of globe from Time Life. It shows this that looks like this, kind of a traditional globe, when the light inside it is off. And then it shows a more of a topographic view when the light is on. That's pretty cool. This might be one of the most interesting ads in the magazine. From Sugar Information Incorporated. And I'm tempted to actually read this almost word for word because it's kind of amazing. Sally coasts beautifully through the day. Gets husband and kids off in the morning. Cleans and scrubs. Bicycles down to the market before lunch, gets back from the bridal shower in time to plan dinner for 10. Okay, so we're not even going to talk about, stereotypical reductive roles of women in the 60s. Okay, so let's skip right past that. What keeps Sally sailing along like it was downhill all the way? Energy with a capital E, as in sugar. It makes the wheels go round. Note to people who won't stand still. Exhaustion may be dangerous. It can even rob you of your resistance to illness. But sugar helps offset exhaustion, puts back energy fast. Synthetic sweeteners put back nothing. And did you know they won't make you thin either? So play safe. Make sure you get sugar every day. People need what sugar's got. 18 calories per teaspoon, and it's all energy. Sally needs energy-less artificial sweeteners like a glassblower needs hiccups. Wow. So this is clearly... So sugar, the sugar lobby, the sugar industry was clearly starting to feel the pressure from artificial sweeteners showing up in foods and sodas and things. And so this was an attempt to try to push the needle the opposite way. Wow. I'm just going to kind of let that ad speak for itself. General Electric window-mounted air conditioners. Buy it now before the summer heat of 1967. We've got a little fashion stuff here. How about that? Another ad from Sylvania. Light bulbs. A matador with a bunny. I hope this isn't the bunny from Monty Python and the Holy Grail, or he's in for it. Monsanto. Can you tell from this picture what this ad is about? It's not about the meat. It's about the fact that you can see all of the meat before you buy it because of the wrapping created by Monsanto. How about that? And Coca-Cola and a burger. An all-American way to end the magazine. So that was a little browse through the magazine. But now, in order to focus on some of these paper sounds a little bit better, I'm going to flip back through the magazine, backwards to front, back to front, with no talking, so we can just listen to the page turning and the paper sounds, okay? Thanks, friends, for being with me again today. I hope this has been an interesting and relaxing time as we consider this copy of Life magazine that has that one thing in common with me, that we came into being on the same month. It's always a little bit of a time machine looking at old magazines like this. It's very interesting to look back on how things used to be. I appreciate your being here. Thank you so much for watching. I never say this, and of course, now me saying at the very end of a video, it means not as many people will hear it, but if you enjoy this video or this channel in general, if you enjoy what I'm trying to accomplish here with this very humble ASMR content, I would love to have you be part of the channel by subscribing. If you'd like this channel and future videos to show up in your subscription list, I would love to have you on board as a subscriber. So please don't forget to subscribe if you like it. Only about a third of the views on this channel are from subscribers. So two-thirds of you view, but then just kind of keep on going. And that's perfectly fine. But if this interests you at all, please hit subscribe before you move on to the next video. I would love to have you on board in this very small Gaslamp family. Thanks again, everybody. Take care of yourselves and take care of each other. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.